So here we are. This is intermediate one, class 29. Let's see who we have today. There we go, first student. What's up, Mr. Isai? Hello, hello. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
There we go. Yep, perfectly clear. Hello, sir.
How about?
Sorry?
How about you?
I'm doing fine right now. It's been just a hot day. So, but yeah. Everything okay. What about you? How was your day?
So far, so good, sir. Maybe a little tired for the work, but everything present to receive the class.
All right. Any problems today at work or everything normal?
Everything normal. Every day is a hard day in my work.
What do you do? What exactly during the day?
To be honest, I am part of the quality control department, but I am not an inspector yet because to become an inspector, I need a license.
Yeah.
The license is given in the United States after do some tests and evaluations. For that reason, I need to improve my English, especially with the vocabulary fluency, listening, because when I speak with some customer or client in the work, I have some problems to understand them.
Oh, I understand now. Okay. Yeah, I remember you told me about that test that you need to take to have your license. All right.
Yeah.
How long does it take to get your license? I mean, that test.
I didn't understand the question.
Ah, you see, because I'm speaking a little faster. Now, the question was, yeah. How long is the process for the test? Like, you do the test, and then how long you have to wait?
It depends, because we must do some theoretical test, and then on oral test, and then there is a part practical.
Oh, okay.
I must to be able to show the evaluator that I am able to manage some tools and some topics about the airplanes. And there is many topics that I must study. But I think it's possible. A little difficult, but it's possible.
Of course, everything is possible. Okay, I understand. I hope this class helps you, and I hope soon you will have your license. Now, just before, sorry, I'm a teacher, so I have to correct. Remember when you use the auxiliary must, you don't say must to, just must and the action you have to do. I must study.
I must study.
Good, all right, cool.
I don't know what you say in English when I speak Spanish, or everything I speak Spanish, like a classmate that we have, everything he says, for me, the use of two after the must is like a colilla.
Yeah, I see. I noticed. But with time, it will just stop. You will see. All right, let's greet everybody else. Hello, Mr. Gilberto Rosa. Mr. Gilberto Rose. How are you today?
I'm fine, sir. Hello. And you? How are you?
Very good. Happy to hear you. How was your work today?
It was difficult. I think it was okay.
Okay. All right. Not so bad. Just normal.
All right. I think so, but so far so good. Some cases is normal. Some cases is rare, but.
Okay, I see. All right, but that's everyday life. Thank you for connecting, sir. Mr. Julio, hello, Mr. Julio. Good evening. Julio not here? All right. Mr. Marlon, hello, Marlon. Oh, there is Julio.
Hello.
Good evening. Welcome, guys. Welcome. Mr. Franklin Flores, hello, Mr. Frank.
Hello. Good evening.
Good evening, sir. Good evening. How's life?
It's good. Thanks, God.
Life is good. All right.
Listen, recently come to the work, and recently I took my dinner.
You had your dinner? Hey, that's good. Early. That's perfect.
Early.
I haven't had it yet. After class, I will have my dinner. Good. Thank you for connecting, Mr. Franklin and Ms. Ariel. Hello, Ms. Ariel. Good evening.
Hi. Good evening.
How are you this night?
I'm happy. I already ate pupusas.
Oh, that doesn't make me happy. That makes me sad, but happy for you. That's good. What kind of pupusas do you eat? Cheese, beans, pork?
Cheese with beans.
Ooh, I love those. With loroco or no loroco? You don't like it?
Yeah, I love loroco. Yes, with loroco.
Oh, yes. That's for me a perfect pupusa. All right, very good. Thank you. Thank you for sharing that with us. Everybody else had dinner or not yet? Just Franklin and Ariel. Julio, you had dinner?
Yes, no, dinner.
Cool, that's awesome. Marlon, you had dinner?
No, I
don't. Not yet? Oh, sad life. Isai, you had dinner already?
Yeah, that's right, sir. I have dinner.
Man, I kind of hate you right now, but that's perfect. Just joking. Gilberto, you had dinner?
Yeah, but I'm hungry.
Still hungry? What do you eat?
Yeah. Continue. The light. What is the light? The light is blinking. Already blinking.
What light?
You need to eat it.
He needs fuel. What do you eat, Gilberto? Oh, he's gone. All right, didn't hear me, maybe. All right, everybody. So, welcome to another day of class. Officially, we start today is Wednesday, the middle of the week. Well, if you rest Saturday and Sunday, good. If you have to work, I'm sorry. But welcome. So let's get started. So let's start with something simple. Do you remember verbs? Verbs? Have you studied verbs in present and in past? No? No, right?
We can refresh.
Of course, we always can refresh them. So since you're experts, I brought a little children game for you. This is for kindergarten. So I suppose this should be an easy game. So the idea is you need to guess what is the verb in those lines or spaces that we have. So in here, you have three spaces. Every little B is one opportunity for a letter. If you don't guess it, you have a punishment. So Mr. Isai, do you have a letter that you want to try?
The letter F.
F. All right. No, we don't have an F. Sorry, Mr. Gilberto.
Letter R?
Letter R.
No.
Marlon.
Me. All right. Me.
Wait, we're in order. Marlon, sorry.
L.
L.
No.
No. Go, Frank. It's your turn now.
No. Is the name of that animal B?
No, but it's only Bravo, verbs.
Echo, echo.
It's verbs.
Oh.
So sorry. It's not verb. B. So give me a letter.
S.
Flight. No.
S. Give me a letter. A. Yeah, yes. We got an S.
C.
C.
Yes.
No. Sorry. No. Ariel, you have a letter?
R.
R?
I said.
Yes. They already said it, guys. Sorry. Another one, Ariel.
O.
O.
No.
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 Letter I. I.
I as letter an Indian? I.
No,
echo, e. Echo.
E. Oh, that's E as in echo. All right. No, sorry, we only have
letter
three opportunities. A? A as in alpha?
A.
No, it's not A. Another letter. C? They already said C.
Sit.
Sit. Oh, so I, let's see. Yeah. Yes, sir. Good job, Mr. Humberto. If I had one pupusa, I would send it to you through Uber Eats, but we don't have service here. So very good. Sit. Now, what is the past of sit, Mr. Julio? What is the past of sit?
Sit.
The past?
Sit. No.
What is the past of sit, Mr. Franklin?
The same or no?
No, Miss Ariel, what is the past of sit?
Sat.
Yes, sat. Sat. S-A-T. Very good. All right. When was the last time, Mr. Isai, when was the last time you sat at the beach?
Approximately, to be honest, 2 years ago.
2 years ago. Jesus, that's a long time. Okay, all right. Very good. Let's see. Mr. Marlon, when was the last time you sat in a movie theater or in the cinema?
More or less 5 years ago.
5 years ago? You don't go to the movies?
Yeah.
Wow.
No, not much.
Not much?
Only Netflix.
Excuse me, of course. That's better. All right. Miss Ariel, when was the last time you sat on a volcano?
I think 4 months ago.
Oh, before quarantine?
Yes. Yes. Before quarantine.
That's excellent. All right. Yes. Tell me.
Teacher, the bird seat have other additional meaning, like the down and the seat.
Didn't understand your question. What do you mean? Like for another bird?
It's so confused for me. The bird seat.
Why?
It's the same action when you down and a child seat.
Yeah, that's seat. Yeah, you sit on a seat.
For your question about the beach, to the visit some place, to the visit the mountain, to the visit the. There is other meaning.
No, I mean seat.
What was your last time? What was your last time that you go to the beach?
No, that you sat. I said. That you sat down at the beach. Like in the sand, on the sand, you sat. You're standing and you sit down. That, yes, that's what I was asking. When was the last time you sat at the beach? Or at a volcano. Good. Let's go with the next verb. Let's try to do it quickly, Gilberto. You're the winner, so you have the chance to guess one letter or the verb.
Okay, letter E.
E. Yes, sir. Wow, you're good at this. Mr. Isai.
Letter F.
F. Nope. Mr. Marlon.
Letter S?
S? No, yes. Sorry. Mr. Franklin.
T.
T. No, sorry. Mr. Ooh. Julio.
B.
B, as in Bravo.
Bravo, yes.
Okay, good. No, sorry. Ms. Ariel.
I
okay. No, sorry. Yes. Mr. Baltasar. Give us a letter. Well,
Sita.
Sorry?
Sita. Last letter.
Z.
Z. Zulu.
Oh, Zulu. Z. Z. Yeah. Oh, okay. Canadian people say Z. They pronounce Z normally. But Z, I guess, is French. But we say Z. No, sorry. Z. Let's see, Gilberto, we're back with you. Help us. Gilberto.
Let me see.
Got it.
Letter L.
L. Okay.
L.
No.
No. All right.
We only have two chances.
Read.
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 All right. Marlo says read. Let's go for read. So that would be R, O, E, A. You saved the group. Read. Nice. You see, if I had some money, I will give you $1 right now. But it's virtual, so sorry. Now, what is the password read?
Read, same, but different pronunciation.
It's the same spelling, but with a different pronunciation, which is, someone already said it, red, like the color, red. So
this is present, red.
No, the present is read. Read.
Read. And the past is
the past,
red.
The pronunciation is red. Correct. The spelling is the same. No changes. But the pronunciation, yes. Let's see. Who has read a horror book? Who has read a horror book? No one?
No.
Really? No one? All right. Let's make it different. Who has read a book? Yes, you have read books.
I have read a book.
Okay. Okay. Very good. Now, which Gibson. Book? Sorry? Okay. Now, who has read a book in English?
Me, but only the majority.
That's not a book. That's obligation.
I tried to. I tried to read a book.
All the time, the reference, the maintenance.
Just three or four pages.
So you only read 3 or 4 pages, Ariel? Only that? Why? You got bored?
Yeah, because I discover a lot of vocabulary that I don't know and I don't understand the book.
That is the point.
That is the point. That's the point. When you read a book, it's a discover your deficiency.
Deficiency.
I know.
Okay.
In my case.
New for me.
My recommendation is when you're starting to learn English or you're beginning, it's a good idea to read, this will sound weird, but children book, because they're adequate to the English that you're learning. And yes, you will find new vocabulary, but you're not going to get frustrated. But if you get a book that is 400 pages and it's all in English, then personally, no, I will read 2 pages and I will just throw it away. Not throw it away, but I won't finish reading. So my recommendation is look online for children or teenagers books. So that will go adequate to the level you have and you might like it and not get bored. Example, who has tried to read the Bible in English? Has anybody tried to read the Bible in English?
Oh, yes, but it's a old English.
Yes.
Modern English.
Yes and no. You can find some transcriptions in kind of modern English. And yes, there are some Bibles that are in very old-fashioned English. So for me, before I used to go to church before a long time ago, I tried. And no, I only read like 10 pages and I just couldn't continue. So that's what I'm saying. Look for a book that is adequate for you. All right, everybody. So that's enough about this activity. Let's get to business. So who remembers the conditionals? How many conditionals we have seen?
Four.
So basically there are four. Mainly we use only three because the zero, it's pretty much very simple. So we already practiced last class first conditional. When do we use first conditional? For what situations? Who remembers?
A real.
Possibility. For, yes, future results. So we use first conditional for future results. If I study, complement? I will pass the level. I am going to pass the level. So you can use any type of future we have seen. Going to, or will, or may, or might. All right? If I don't eat for 2 days, what will happen?
Maybe will you get sick?
You will get sick. Okay.
I will lose the weight.
I will lose weight? Good diet, right?
No.
Two days.
You will look fit.
Yes. Shape. Maybe I will look fit or in shape. All right. Very good. That could be. Or I will get sick. Pretty bad illness. I will get a headache, possibly. All right. Now, if I don't drink water for 5 days,
die.
I will die?
It's possible that you will die.
Okay, you will die, definitely. Very possible. Well, I don't know, right? But how many days can a human survive with no water? Do you know?
Only five.
Only five?
Depends on the weather.
Okay, all right. Today. I guess personally, I would just survive 2 days, then I'm dead. I need water all the time. All right, so that is first conditional, future results. Then today we will work again with second conditional. So what was second conditional? Who remembers?
Simple past, but okay. The result will plus days verb.
Good. So in this case, because it's unreal situations or hard to happen possibilities, we use simple past on the if, and we use would or could in the result. Very good, guys. I guess you are good for this. So let's start with a little short, simple reading because we need some vocabulary. Let's see, Mr. Baltasar, could you please read the title?
If I won the lottery.
All right. So we already discussed this before. What is the chance that we can win the lottery in El Salvador?
1%. 1,000,000%.
1 in 1,000,000? 0.000%.
Okay.
Never.
No. One number into a 2,200 numbers.
22,000. 22,000. Okay. That's actually true. By the way, now that you mentioned that number, do you know what is 2,200? Have you ever heard this expression? No? Or 1,500. Someone knows what is 1,500?
It's a way to avoid long quantity of zero, I think.
Very true. Very good. So we use this. If you see the chat right now, what numbers did I write on the chat? Can someone tell me the regular way?
1,500. Okay.
Okay, so 1500. What is 1,500? Is 1,500.
Yeah.
Exactly. Uh-huh. So when you have round numbers, you can use this type of expression. Instead of saying 2,200, you can only say 2,200.
Oh,
now, let's say
it's common.
Yes.
Sure, it's common.
That's very common.
Expression.
Yes. Now, it's not so formal, but it's not informal either. Any American would use that. For example, I'm selling my car. How much is it? Oh, 4,500. How much is in regular numbers? 4,500. What is that?
4,500.
4,500.
4,000.
4,000.
500. Yeah.
So I can just make it very short, and that's why this is using, of course, spoken way. You don't write it down. You don't really put messages in that in those terms. It's only spoken. And when you already have kind of, not confidence, but it's not something very formal. Yes?
Actually, it can be used in when you are talking about engines, but I don't know how do you say cilindrada.
So cylinders. You can,
cilindrada.
Oh. I'm not sure about that.
Cubical
centimeters? Mm-hmm.
It's a technical English.
Yes. Cubical centimeters?
Yes. Yes, it's technical English.
Okay, all right. Oh, like like the cars are 1800 engine?
Yeah.
I see. Yes, normally we use this also for money. It's very useful for money.
Teacher.
Yes.
I heard in sometime that expression when someone to refer to the time, by military expression.
Oh, yes. Military hour, which is a different story. Yes, they use that kind of, I will see you at the 300 hours, which is 3 a.m., if I'm not mistaken.
300,
Exactly, 300, or the 3300. Mm-hmm. Exactly. Very good, people. Now, let's start the reading. Mr. David, could you please start reading from here, to house?
To have, mm-hmm. I can imagine what my life will be like if I won the lottery. Wow, I could do so many things, and my life will be so different. I would love the chance to change my life with the money. The first thing I would do is buy a big new house.
Okay, thank you very much, David. Now, we're going to implement this kind of reading. If I hear one mistake, a little mistake, I will tell you stop. And you need to select another person to read that part and read it correctly. So, do we understand?
That word.
Oh, no, you will stop reading if you make a mistake. Example, if you say, I live, I would tell you, sorry, Franklin, choose somebody else. And you cannot continue reading.
Let's start again.
Yeah, not start again, but you cannot read anymore. Another person needs to help. Cool.
Okay.
All right. So let's see. We were good here. So, Mr. David, choose a victim.
Ariel.
All right, Ariel. From I leave until new car. Go.
And I've always dreamed
the English, Ariel, your English, your internet is low.
I could.
Don't pass the test. Don't pass the test.
Wait.
Really?
All right. Try to do it again. Restart again.
Hello.
Yes, we hear you.
I live in a small apartment. And all of a living in a big city country. All money, I could buy anything you want. I don't have a car now. So I need a car.
All right, sorry, Ariel. I hear you, but there are some parts that we cannot hear you. We sound like a little robotic. Sorry, but I understood so far. No mistakes, I guess. So sorry, Ariel. Thank you. All right. So let's continue. Ariel, choose another victim. I guess we can hear you. No, we lost you, Ariel. She disconnected.
Sorry, teacher. I lost the network.
That's what we hear. Okay, choose a victim, please.
Franklin.
All right, Frank. Of course. Let's go. Finish that part.
Oh, okay, or I might even buy a new motorcycle. I like motorcycles, and I can imagine myself driving down the highway with the wind in my hair.
Good reading. That's good. Thank you, Franklin. Select another victim from, of course, to pay for it.
Sorry, teacher. Teacher.
Yeah.
Lorena wants to access to the platform.
Who wants to access?
Lorena, I think.
Lorena.
But I don't have nothing here from her. Is she following the correct link? She's not using another link? Let me check what's up because I don't have it.
Okay.
Because I don't have anything coming up here. Maybe she's using something else. So if you're checking, tell her to look for the last link or someone resend it to her, please. Because I don't have any request. Please, please, please. Or maybe it's my internet. All right. Let me know what she says, please, because my WhatsApp is loading. Sorry, I don't use WhatsApp in class. Okay. We heard that. Cool. All right. Let's see. Yeah, there she is. One second. Is she here? There she is. Yeah, there we go. She's connecting. Thank you, Mr. Gilberto. There she is. Hello, Lorena. Is Lorena?
Thank you. I'm here.
All right, good. Thank you for connecting. All right, guys, let's continue. So you were selecting a victim, Mr. Franklin.
Lorena. Awesome.
All right, Lorena. So we're reading right now. So can you see?
Easier for her.
Can you see the screen? The parts that I marked.
Yes, I just read.
Yeah, just that's it. Just read.
Of course. If I want the lottery, I should give some of the money to charity.
I would
probably give me money to a charity that helps children. Mm-hmm. Also, if any of my friends needing anything, I could help them pay for it.
Okay, that's enough. Thank you very much. All right, I guess you pronounce this one okay. Everyone, charity. Charity.
Charity.
If that is difficult to pronounce, it's okay to say charity. Charity.
Charity. Okay.
What? Charity. It sounds better. Charity. Charity.
Charity.
You know what is charity. All right. No?
No.
Okay. Like, I have a lot of money and there are a lot of children outside that don't have money or houses or shoes. So I come and say, hey, here, to this company, please take my money and help those children. Charity.
Okay.
Yes, more or less. I don't want to use Spanish, but do you understand what is charity?
Yes, I understand.
There is one specific word in Spanish.
Yeah, but we don't need that right now. All right, but we understand the idea in English. All right, so charity is helping the ones in need. That's it. Uh-huh. Good. Lorena, choose a victim.
Franklin?
He already read. Another victim.
Cesar Sanchez.
All right, Cesar, are you here, Cesar? I guess he's not here yet.
Darío.
All right, Darío, I don't think. Is Darío here? No.
No.
Samuel?
Samuel, no either. Jesus Christ.
Oh my God. Ariel?
She already read. Keep trying.
Luis?
He's not here yet. Jesus. Keep trying.
Isaí González.
All right. There he is. All right, Isaí. Kill it.
Okay. I know many people that have student loans, and I could help them pay the loans back. That will make them very happy. Plus, if I want a lot of money, I will Certainly. Say some of it in the bank.
Good job. All right. Just one little change in this one. Everyone, loans. Loans.
Loans.
It's a little ooh over there. Loans. Loans. It's a little
loans.
Student loans. Everyone knows what is a loan, loans, right? Money that you ask the bank to give you. Loan.
Okay.
Yes, everyone knows what is a loan? Yes?
No.
I need to buy a car.
Yeah, okay.
I don't have money. I go to the bank and I tell them, hey, can you give me a loan of $3,000?
It's a credit.
Yeah, we can say that. It's when someone gives you something like money, and that is a loan. Normally with the bank or people that have money and they give you money, that's loan. Now.
It's a credit.
Yeah, it's a credit. We can say that. But yeah, it's a credit with the bank. We can say it. Mm-hmm. Now, we can use loan also as a verb. For example, I have this ball right here. Example, right? I have a basketball. And you tell me, hey, can you loan me your ball, your basketball? So loan, it's another way to say land. Yes, everyone?
It's a similar verb.
Yes,
your synonyms. Hey, can you loan me your car? Or can you lend me, which is the most appropriate. All right? Good. All right, people. We still have more. Let's see, Zay, choose a victim.
Okay. I have the list. Mr. Saul.
All right, Saul. Show us.
Yes. Also, I think that if I won a huge amount of money.
A what? What?
I don't know how to say.
It's very using.
Ask for help. Ask someone to help you only with that word. If they get it, you can continue. Ask for help.
Walter, can you help me?
How do you say that word, Mr. Baltasar?
Huge.
All right. So, Saul, huge. Start again.
Okay.
Thank you, Baltasar. Okay.
Also, thank you, Walter. Also, I think that if I won a huge amount of money.
That's not what Baltasar said. Say it again, Baltasar.
Huge.
There is a G at the end. Huge. All right. Start again, Saul.
Okay. Also, I think that if I won a huge.
Huge. Make the ch. It's like saying huge, but you make vibration. Huge.
Like huge. Orange juice. Like orange huge. Juice.
Huge.
No.
Also.
Not really. Huge. Try it again, Saul.
Okay. Also, I think that if I won a huge amount of money, I could open a business. I love to cook.
Uh-huh.
And I have always wanted to open a restaurant. With all the money, I could open a fancy restaurant.
Good. All right. We can take that value. Restaurant.
That's true.
It's just an R, very small R.
Huge.
Restaurant. Good. Mister, I select the next one. Let's see. Mr. Gilberto, you haven't read, right?
Yes.
You read?
Okay. No.
Oh, okay. Go ahead, then.
Okay. However, I know one thing I will not do is travel. I have a friend who won 100,000. A friend.
Oh, okay. Okay.
I have a friend who won 100,000 in the lottery 3 years ago. She took the money and traveled for 3 months. I think she is crazy. Traveling is nice, but then she had nothing left after her vacation.
All right. That was okay, we can say. Let's see. Vacation. Everyone, vacation.
Vacation.
It's kind of a vague, kind of a small vacation or vacation.
Vacation.
Mm-hmm. Very good. and travel. It's a small like when you go to the doctor. Travel. Wow. Travel. It's not travel, if you pronounce it like that. Travel, travel. And finish it, Mr. Gustavo.
I think, however, that the only problem with dreaming about the money I can win is that I have never even played the
lottery. Stop. I have never what?
Even.
Ask for help.
Even.
Uh-huh. Start even. Everything again, Gustavo.
Okay. I think, however, that's the only problem with dreaming about the money I could win is that I have never even played the lottery before. As they say, you can't win if you don't play.
Good. All right, people. Now, is this an easy reading? Is this an easy reading? Do you consider this easy?
Yes.
It's easy.
What?
Only with this. It's only with this.
Ah, exactly. Uh-huh. So it's an easy reading, basic reading, but there are some words that we still need to practice.
For new vocabulary.
Exactly. So let's go over them some just really quick. Let's see pronunciation of this.
Imagine
all the people. Let's see. What is the next one? This one.
The past of the verb want is correct to say wanted.
Yes, you can say wanted or wanted. Okay. Remember, once I mentioned that if you have a letter T after the letter N, you can omit the letter T. So want has a T. So that's why you can say wanted or wanted.
Thank you.
That's no problem. Okay, like center, internet.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's go with the next one. What is this pronunciation?
Chancer.
Chance.
It's between an I and an A. Chance. Yes. Give me a chance. And that's what we say in Spanish. Hey, dame un chance. It comes from the word chance. This is the correct word. So give me a chance.
Mm-hmm. Or, give me a chance.
Yeah, that's what chance. Exactly.
Give me a chancecito.
Exactly, but it's chance. That is the correct expression. Good job. Let's go with the next one. Let's see, there was another word here. No, I guess this was fine and easy. This one.
Charity.
Exactly. Good. This one?
Probably.
Experts, good job. Probably. Let's see. There was another one. Oh yeah, that one. Where is it? Lost it.
In the last line of that paragraph. I would certainly say no in the first paragraph, but in the last.
Line. There you go. Sir, good. We're almost getting there. But yes, what is the pronunciation, guys, for this?
Certainly.
All right. So two ways you can say it. Yes, you can say certainly. It's a little E-A, certainly. Now, you want to sound a little more native? Certain with your throat.
Certainly.
Yes.
Native pronunciation.
It's okay to say certainly. Certainly. It's okay. Certainly. But like I say, it depends. Even natives will pronounce it in the two different ways. So very good. Let's go. Let's see. I guess that was it. Oh, this one. What is it?
Loans.
It's a little loan. Because if you say longs, it sounds like this in the chat. Longs. What are longs? The part in of money, your body, exactly, that you use to breathe, lungs. Uh-huh. You see? Lungs?
Teacher,
lungs.
What is the singular, the plural form of that verb? Is
what?
With letter S. Lungs?
Lungs or lung?
No, for the highlight.
Oh, loans. That is plural. Loan is only singular without the S. Loan, loan. Loan. This is plural.
The S is for the grammar student. Have student loan.
This one here. It's not a verb. This is a noun. So this is plural. Loans, loans, préstamos, loans. Mm-hmm. Exactly. Student loans. Good. All right, anybody. Any other word that you want to review before we move on? Because we have more activities.
Huge.
Saul is an expert now. What is it, Saul?
Huge.
Ah,
huge.
There you go.
A huge.
Huge. Everyone, huge.
Huge.
Huge. It's like saying huge, teacher, but with vibration. Teacher, huge. Tell me.
It's better if you write in the chat the correct way to the phonetic.
Okay, if that helps you.
No.
There you go.
Huge.
Huge.
Okay.
But remember,
let me see.
Check it.
Hey, huge. It appears.
No, it's there.
Huge. Huge.
So it's like huge, but you make a little vibration with your throat. Huge. Huge.
Huge.
Huge. Mm-hmm. Many people only say huge. Oh, it's a very huge house, man. No, huge house. Huge house. Good. All right. Any other before we move on? Are we good?
Huge.
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 Exactly.
Huge. It's better for us.
Yes. Huge. All right. So we have some questions here. Let's see what you remember. So, Mr. Caesar, could you please read question one?
What would the person not buy if she won the lottery?
Uh-huh. So what was not mentioned, or what did they mention they wouldn't or she wouldn't buy? Apartment, car, motorcycle, house.
What would the person not buy?
What do you remember?
I think I missed that part.
Oh yeah, you just got here.
What?
Yeah.
Don't worry. The others? What would the person not buy if she won the lottery? What wasn't mentioned here? Did they mention an apartment?
Motorcycle.
Did they mention a motorcycle? Did they mention a car?
I remember some apartment. A travel. No, say a travel.
Okay. Somebody else? Uh-huh. So let's check. Let's look first. Apartment. Do we have more words that says apartment? Look. So he lives in a small apartment.
Yeah, at least.
So maybe not. House is here. So he will certainly buy a house. Motorcycle?
Yeah.
Here.
Like.
Car? Here. So what he would not buy?
Apartment,
exactly, because he lives in an apartment. Uh-huh. Aye, aye, aye. Next question, Mr. Saul, can you read it?
Yes. What would the person not do if she won the lottery?
Uh-huh. What would the person not do if she won the lottery? Who can tell me?
Give money to friends.
Give money to friends?
Yeah.
Anybody else agree?
Yes.
Yes. They never mentioned give money to friends. Never. They mentioned that a friend took a trip, but he never said, I will give it to friends. Would you give money to friends if you won the lottery?
It depends on how many.
My friend is in need.
Yes.
Okay. Good. Yes. All right. Okay. Very good. All right, guys, so because of time, we cannot finish. You can do this part on your own. This link, it's here in Schoology. there. We're already under Semana Cinco, so it's right here. Right there, right there. And I will send it to your chat right now also. So you can read if you want to. Not a homework, but recommendation. Cool. Let's get to the group work of today. Any question right now? Everything good? All right. So, would you like to be a president? Would you like to be a president, Mr. Gilberto?
Yes, I would like to be a president. Of the Republic of El Salvador, or where?
In general, would you like to be a president? And then we guess if El Salvador is a good option. Would you like to be a president?
The grade on the school.
Of a country. I was never the president in school. That's terrible. I wasn't good. All right. So, Mr. Marlon, what country would you like to be the president of?
I would like to be president in Canada, for example.
Canada. Good. They have a very nice president.
Maple.
Mm-hmm. Of the Maples. All right. Isai, what country would you like to be president of?
In English, I don't know. But maybe it is Russia.
Russia. Oh, Russia. So you would be Isai Putin.
Putin.
Yeah. It's all great.
That is it. That guy, I admire the dude. I admire that president. He is not only a president. That guy, I don't know.
Franklin Trump, maybe.
Trump. You want to be Donald Trump? Okay. I don't know. Isai Trump would be funny. Ariel, if you could be a president, what country would you choose?
Probably Argentina.
Argentina, okay. They're in a little bit of trouble, I guess, with the president and the economy. Okay, but it's
very difficult, right? This moment.
Oh my God, more troubles.
Very hyperinflation.
Yeah, kind of El Salvador, but in a bigger scale.
Oh no.
Yeah.
But with less criminals. All right, Lorena, what country would you like to be the president of?
Costa Rica.
Oh, okay.
Costa Rica.
That's a good country.
Yeah. They have a good system implemented related to the education situation, economic in the country. Mm-hmm. Maybe the condition is better to the region.
To the region.
Very good.
Okay. All right. That's true. Maybe. Costa Rica. Sure. Tell me.
Why do you use the preposition of in the end when you say the question?
Oh, very good.
President.
For questions, it's not like in Spanish that we use the preposition in the beginning, like de qué país. Mm-hmm. When you are making a question, you use the preposition at the end. Example.
Like
where are you looking
where are
from?
You from?
Where are you from? What are you looking for? Who are you with? You don't say, with who are you? No, that's very Spanish. You say, who are you with? So instead of saying, of what country, you say, what country would you like to be the president of? Mm. Did I answer your question? So the prepositions in questions go at the end of the question.
Is a rule always go in the end?
Yes. Because the structure is normally you have a WH question or a WH word, which is what, which, why, they go in the beginning. Cool. Now, informally, you might hear a preposition in the beginning, but still it's not really correct and people don't really talk like that. So yes, prepositions go at the end. Good?
Only everybody? Spanish.
Yeah, only Spanish is different. We have...
In order to sound less pipil.
All right.
Pacachito.
Huh?
City. Near to Sucitoto, no.
I am from Opico.
Pacachico.
I am from Opico, so I am pipil.
You are from Opico.
Yes.
Barranca Honda.
No. Sitio del
Volcanoes people.
I'm from Sitio del Niño. I was on the news recently.
Sitio del Niño.
Yes. Yes, sir. All right. Very good. Don't come and visit me. It's not good. No, it's pretty good here. It's safe. It's safe. All right. So talking about precedents. So today you will work in groups and you will analyze the following situations. Example one, Gustavo, can you read the part that says guns?
Guns.
Mm-hmm. I don't know if you see my screen.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
And guns. If I were president, I would read the letters.
No, don't worry. Don't worry. So you will need to choose one of these four options. You can only choose one of those options. And you need to tell us why. Example, would you allow everyone to own a gun? If you say yes, why? Will you allow only adults without criminal records to own a gun? Why? Et cetera, et cetera. So you would choose only one and tell me why you choose it. Part number two. Can you read it, Mr. Caesar? For number two.
Education. If I were present, I'd...
Okay, very good. That's enough. So education, the same thing. You will choose one of this and you will explain why you will choose it. And the last one, Mr. Luis, could you please read it? Oh, we have more. We have three.
Okay. Okay. Fast food. Is if I was president, I would.
Exactly. Thank you. So the same thing, you will choose one and explain why. And the last one, teacher, tell me.
Teacher. And the statement three, after the preposition or conditional if, appears was and nowhere.
Why? Finally, someone. I was waiting for someone to catch it. So what
extra did we... point, please don't forget.
All right, I might consider it. So what did we discuss last time for this? Look, if I were. And here we have
that is normal,
was. Yeah. So exactly. So we would need to use were. So this one is a mistake. Good. Someone caught it.
Hey.
It's good. All right. I might.
A point.
All right. I might give you a point. You had too many points.
Inspector, remember.
All right. Hey. And the last one is?
So that means that I don't need to make any action?
No, just a quiz. Not the exam, no. Just a quiz. The short version.
No. All right.
No, we cannot do that. Well, let's see. If you find more mistakes, maybe. So let's see. David, can you read the last one, number four?
Recycling. If I was president, I'd...
So recycling, if I would need to change it, exactly, if I were a president. So this link, it's on Schoology, but I will send it to the chat right now. Or if you want to take a screenshot, you can go ahead and do it. The link is already there because you will use it. So let me move it and let me make it a little smaller. I guess I cannot make it smaller. All right, so take two screenshots, I guess. Do you have it?
Only for the
can number, you share two, the link,
number,
please.
Number four.
Yeah, I already sent it to the chat. Tell me if you have it. From one to four, all of them. But you need to choose only from every statement, you will choose only one option. You have four options, you will choose only one for every situation. Yes? And you will discuss why you choose that statement. We get it? Is it clear? No?
Clear.
If it's not, tell me so I can explain it.
Clear like
horchata.
Clear like horchata, clear like acelguate. Yes? No?
Clear.
All right.
No,
so,
no.
So I repeat, no. You will work in groups, you will read the statements for every situation, for every topic, you would choose only one of those letters, A, B, C, or D. You would choose only one. And tell me why you choose that option. Better now? All right. All right. I will send the link again. Resend it. There we go. It's already there. Also is in Schoology. You can find it here. It's If I Were the President. That is the link. It's under Semana Cinco. Very good. So I'll separate you in groups right now. Oh, a lot of people is connecting now. Ah, wait. Christian Calles. Hello, Jose. Thank you for connecting.
Hello, teacher. Sorry, I was trying to connect.
Oh, don't worry. Do you have problems connecting?
Yeah, yeah. The internet is very...
Oh, the internet. Yeah. Oh, I see. Christian Streets. Hello, Chris.
Christian
Streets. Welcome, sir. All right, guys. So I will need to separate you in groups. For the ones that just came to the group, your group will explain to you what we are doing. So I'll separate you right now. It's your homework. So let's go. Accept it. You only had 10 minutes for this, so gotta be quick. Don't take a long time. Accept it. Accept it, accept it. Accept the invite, accept the invite. So right now what they're doing is, since we already saw future and the first conditional reviewed, now we have to review again second conditional, and they're going to apply it into something more serious than just suppositions. I mean, this is supposition, but with more reality into it. So that's what they're doing right now. And I will drink some water if you don't mind. Faces. It's a little sweaty. Sorry. I mean, we all sweat. I don't have makeup. Like those YouTubers and TV people or actors or actresses. There we go. So let me go to the groups and see what's going on.
I were president.
If I were, okay.
Think about the number.
Okay. It doesn't matter.
Okay.
Never change. Must to use where for that. In this case,
that is the right structure.
This is a rule, proper rule.
For that thank reason, you.
Always where.
Good teacher, Frank.
Where.
That's perfect.
Hey, Remy, right. Teacher, extra point, please. Don't forget.
I already gave you one today. We will have a limit of points during the day. I already gave you one.
All right. I can say to you tomorrow.
All right, but with a different mistake. All right, guys, have to move. Hey, Mr. Julio.
I'm sorry, I lost the connection.
Don't worry, sir. I don't know until what part you heard. Did you see what the activity was going to be? Or no?
Yes, when you select the group, I lost my
feet. Ah, okay, I see. No worries, my friend. I will send you to a group right now. Let me see. I'll send you with Ariel, Gilberto, and Jose. Is that good?
Okay.
All right, cool. Here we go. Accepted. Where's David? So in case David gets disconnected, he already sent me a message saying that his battery is very low. Oh, actually, he has no battery. So let's see how long it lasts. I'm just answering people that had problems right now, either with connection. Let's see, good evening, I will connect a few minutes late. Now I got it to bring my, oh, okay. Another student says he connected late because his wife has a medical condition. Of course, I won't mention what it is. Mr. Juan Carlos Molina says he won't be able to connect due to a car situation, car problem, car broke down. There you go. All right, let me go with them right now. Let's see.
Recycling.
If
I were president, I would make laws about recycling, offer recycling options for people that want to do it. Make everyone. But
a little cunt.
Yeah. Yes.
You can just shoot cunt for escopeta. How this escopeta?
Shotgun.
Shotgun.
Mm-hmm. No, I think not.
Yep, shotgun. Shotgun.
Shotgun. Mm-hmm. So for the
for
second
me.
One.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. For me, the second.
Resource, we don't have resource to pay maybe the college or the university. So many young people want to study in the university, but they cannot because they don't have too much money to
use the boy.
Sorry?
Okay. Okay, it's good.
Yeah, that's my point because for example here my neighbor, they are a lot of young guys that they want to continue studying, but they don't have enough money to pay the university, so they stop their education. Maybe they don't finish the college or the bachillerato because they can pay it too much money. So I think letter C is fine for me.
And that the education going to be free for everyone, but we don't have the budget to give
the bills.
The country is like a house, but it's a big, big house. But someone has to work in order to steal the benefits.
Because I really consider that if we implement responsible management of the plastic, could be useful and not too too dangerous for the environment.
If you could select the letter B for them, the ones who they're wealthier. How do you say it? Rich people?
Wealthier? Wealthy?
Wealthier. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. If you are wealthy, you can pay more than the poor people.
Mm. Free for everyone. I think maybe we can, teacher, how do you say, like, bajar de precio?
Low prices or low costs? Yeah.
Yeah, low price. Yeah, not free education, just low the price, because when the people pay for something, I think that they are more interested for something like that. It's different when it's free, because when it's free, all people didn't pay attention or something like that. But when you pay at least a low quantity, maybe $5 per month or $10, I don't know, they're going to interested more about education.
It could be, but I know some students that they have a lot of money and they pay the best college, the best university, and they don't care about the study because they have money. They don't.
What word?
Ban.
We're talking about the letter D. I don't know. It's not allowed to the citizens, the fast food.
It's like prohibited. Or it's like, yes, it's a boy. It's like a boy or
prohibited.
Yes, is another way to say that word.
It's the correct word to don't allow the fast food to the citizens, right? Uh-huh. Okay. You have to think about the same a balance to the citizens, because some persons
study says that must ban the fast food, because the children is developed tendency to be heavy.
Lorena.
Man.
Lorena. I think that the letter C is a better option.
Yes.
The letter Charlie.
Yes. Yes.
Because imagine that. El Salvador is a big house, one family. What's happened with the nowadays? The people is eating more fast food.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And the number four. For, let's see, for a better management of the plastic.
If we if we implement responsible management.
Yes, for me it's letter B, because it's not extremely.
No. It depends for the fire.
I think so that economy.
They went to...
Yeah, I think that is okay.
Letter B. Mm-hmm. Four.
And for the last.
Who was a president? Do you know always when I'm going to speak, the teacher connect with in our group?
I think he knows when you're going to speak.
I can feel it. I feel the presence.
Yeah.
You feel the I don't know, the...
I have the feeling.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. If I was present, I'd offer recycling option for people that want to do it, because I think that all we have a lot of things that we know that we can recycle, but we don't know where is the place that we have to put these things. I mean,
all right. Oh, just let them wear for one more minute or less than that, 30 seconds by themselves. And then we're going to come back so we can share what we have discussed so far. I'm here, just waiting. All right, let me go one more round, check what they're doing, if they have finished, so we can go back.
We can get a better planet.
How do you say fauna?
It is like the same.
We like.
You can say wildlife, but it's fauna. Fauna. It's fauna. Correct. Fauna.
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 And wildlife,
basically what you're saying, to be honest, I'm not sure if that only applies for animals, like wild in the open. I don't know if that would include.
Okay.
I guess you can say that. Yeah, I mean, wildlife is everything that is wild, not domesticated. But fauna, it's just everything, all the animals, domestic, non-domestic, wild. Oh, okay. That's it. Mm-hmm. Cool.
They throw the old off.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. It's a worse host. It's necessary to create a law to be recycled, but I don't know what option is
better.
D, ban all unnecessary plastic. Ban all unnecessary plastic, so as plastic bag and throw pajilla. I think that a throw is pajilla.
Throw. Let me look in Google. It's straw.
Yeah, that's straw. The object that you use to drink sodas, juices.
Can.
Desechable.
No, what you said, Franklin. Bahia. Popote.
Pajilla. Ah.
Ah, hey, hey, teacher.
But you reached your limit of points today. Sorry, I cannot give you more.
No, but but I can stay till tomorrow, to next tomorrow.
Accumulated.
To the next level, no?
All right, this is not the okay. Giselle.
If you don't... To share with us.
There you go. You can pass it to your
class. Or give me a point.
There you go. Pass it to them. It's transferable. Almost finished, guys?
Yeah.
All right.
The last one we have.
No, but maybe in my case, I don't have the opportunity to get two cars, so I have to buy one car, and I sell my own car.
But the new car is better than the old car.
Sometimes and sometimes, no, I am looking for offers.
you are all a dealer.
It's a coyote.
A coyote.
Ten coyorón. Big coyote. All right.
Smart man. What car are you selling? You're selling a car?
Actually, I have Mitsubishi Mirage.
Oh, okay. The small one.
Yeah, no.
Or the old one.
The coupe.
Oh, okay. That's cool.
2000, yeah. It's two doors. The engine is the... I don't remember.
1.6? No, smaller.
No, 1.5.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's very economic.
It's the sport engine of this line of car.
That's cool.
It's standard.
Okay, that sounds cool. 2000, you say? Mirage. Because yes. the new Mirage are very, like, small, right?
Yes.
Yeah,
they're horrible. Well, for me, sorry. The classic looks better, right?
Yes. Actually, the my one is the coupe.
Yeah, but those are cooler. The new one's not. They changed the line. Okay, that one's cool. And what are you planning to get?
Maybe one with four doors.
Okay, like a Lancer?
No, I don't have enough money.
Ah, don't lie.
But a 2006 Lancer is not that expensive. They're going cheaper now. Well, yeah, for me too. That's why I don't have one.
But maybe I was thinking on a Corolla 96.
But the price of those are not so cheap. I mean, they're good cars, but...
Yeah.
But you cannot find it lower than 3,000, maybe? Maybe a little more expensive?
It is possible.
Okay, you see? Uh-huh. Okay, that's cool. Another level. Corollas are cool.
Yeah.
All right. Actually, are you finished, guys? Sorry. Oh, sorry. Yes. What do you say?
No problem.
All right, cool. All right, then. So let's go back because it's time. Okay. All right, calling all the crew. Please present yourself to the main hangar. All of you are about to get a super bonus. All right. Almost everyone back, only 15. Someone escaped. Yeah, I don't see. Let's see, Lorena is here. There is Ariel. Let's see, where's Marlon? Marlon, are you here? No, there's Marlon. I see him. Mr. Streets is here. All right, cool. So I guess everyone is back. Were you able to finish the discussion? Yes? No?
Yes.
Cool. So, now, there are no wrong or right answers about this. This was basically your opinion. All right. So let's see what is it? Who's the last person here? Julio Alberto. Now, Mr. Julio. So let's start with guns. What option did your group choose if you guys were presidents?
OK.
Okay, and I know not listening to another point what the selection, pero for me is
pero por mí, but for me.
I'm sorry. I miss Spanish English.
It happens.
Sometimes he forgets.
Me too.
All right.
For more security in the country is I select the letter H, I love everyone, the don't.
Jesus Christ. So for more security.
Yes, for me, yes, because the people, the people for another people is a little scar inside in the house.
Okay.
I think so.
All right. So pretty much like United States, you have the right to have a gun. Well, many of the states. Okay.
Yes.
Now, can you use it outside or only to keep it in the house?
Only keep it in my house.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, that sounds, well, that could be valid. Let's see, Mr. Christian Calles, what did your group choose for guns? Were you in the same group with Julio?
We decided that I will, I will allow Obladul without a criminal record to...
Okay, we lost you at the end, but I heard.
Or exterior.
There you go, and I hear you. So you will allow all adults without any criminal record. Okay, yes. That sounds cool. Mr. Jose Castro, were you in the same group? No?
No, not this okay. Year.
What do you guys choose for number one?
We choose the letter C.
Okay. Only allow people who go hunting to own a gun.
Yeah.
Okay, so I cannot have a gun in my house, only if I have a license of hunters.
Exactly, yes, because I was talking about this country, right? Mm-hmm. This country, many people have a gun in their house and they don't have license. So they shoot, they kill, and they don't have license. So for me, if I were president, I will put a law to protect my people.
Okay. You know,
to give a license. Mm-hmm. If you wanna get a gun, or if you wanna buy a gun, choose or show your license.
To your hunter's license. Okay.
Yeah.
What about if I want to go, I want to hunt criminals? Is that allowed?
It's a black. Circuit break.
Just joking.
For that reason, the letter B is the better option.
Right.
For criminals, I have another law.
Oh, geez. All right. Cool. That sounds
like
martial law.
Yeah.
If you're going to hunt criminals,
congressman,
you.
What do you say?
If you're going to
the criminal doesn't think in the law.
No,
I know. That's why I'm saying for criminals I have a
different law. What do you say, Julio? Was it you or Luis? I don't know if it was Baltasar or Luis. I don't know.
If you will hunt hunting. Criminal, you will become a punisher.
Yeah, exactly. You see? But I'm a hunter.
For criminal, okay, if I found a criminal with a gun that he don't have license, I will cut his hand.
Jesus Christ. All right.
Wow. That's the law.
We will have a lot of people handicapped in this country. A lot of people with no hands. All right.
Oh, yeah.
I like that option. All right. Let's go with the next one. Education. Mr. Franklin, what did your group choose for education?
We chose the better option. It's letter C.
Letter C. Make education free for those who cannot afford to pay for it. Okay. That sounds interesting. Very good. Anybody else chose letter C?
Yeah.
Yes?
Education.
Yes, yes. Okay.
Make education free for those who cannot afford to pay. All right. Who chose letter D? Did someone choose D? No?
Yes. Me? Yes.
Make education free for everyone?
Yes.
Yes, make education free. Change the letter free for obligation for everyone.
Okay. All right.
I think that the answer must be a rational answer.
Mm-hmm.
I think always that the country is like a big house. It's mm-hmm. like our house. Someone have to work in order to keep the benefits inside of house. Okay. If all benefits are free for everybody, what's happened with that house?
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. You won't have that.
If the number D, uh-huh. I think that's good way to return part of the our taxes.
No, but it's not sustainable.
Sustainable.
No, but remember, depends. But in this moment, uh-huh. you are the president. You are politician.
It's my obligation. Take care
provide the education with the people doesn't
it's
have
my obligation
resource
care, save money with it all my brothers
all right don't okay
my...
like
and
I said
the reason because we aren't politic people
exactly that's why we're not politicians but there is no right or wrong answer about this. This is just your opinion. We're not presidents, but
I'm gonna call yes. Nuevas ideas, pues.
These people, all right. All right, guys. Don't worry, I know. We're just joking right now. All right. So, very good, people.
But don't forget.
They're going to ban my videos because you're mentioning political parties. All right, guys. So for fast food, anybody chose D? Just asking. Anybody chose D for fast food? Ban all fast food or no?
No.
Nobody chose D?
No.
Okay. I guess the majority chose C for this one? No?
Yes.
No, B.
Oh,
B.
Letter B.
For children only. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that's because it's the better age to learn a good habit.
Oh,
yeah, what's we did it well personally. I never had fast food when I was a kid. When they offered me chicken, it was because it was my birthday, I mean, campero or something.
<Hey. laughs>
But nice, besides
for that,
that
is in the end,
no, pellejo.
Yeah,
the hospital is
skin.
Cool.
Exactly. All right, recycling. Who chose letter A for recycling?
No.
Nobody chose A?
No. Oh, it's dangerous for the country.
Maybe we make a confused with letter C.
Okay. So
No. It's okay. Letter C is the is
cool one. Make everyone recycle their plastic?
No, only B.
Yes.
Okay. D? Oh, B. Offer recycling options for people that want to do it.
Letter C.
Letter C. Make everyone recycle.
Everyone recycling.
Yes.
But what happened with the other material? Because
uh-huh. only
C
plastic.
Is just for a plastic.
Uh-huh. What's happened?
What about D?
But the plastic is
no. It's only plastic.
It's 80% of the product to recycling.
Mm-hmm.
Trash.
Yeah, because the rest. Yeah. For the rest, we have programs, I guess.
What about the letter D? It's better option.
Ban all unnecessary plastics, such as plastic bags and straws.
No,
so you...
in order to get extra tax and motivate the people that is better.
No.
No.
Letter B is the best.
Letter Bravo. B yeah. Offer recycling options.
No. No.
Okay.
Letter B. Yeah. You know why? Let me tell you.
Is going to recycle?
Let me tell you.
No.
Jose wants to talk.
Remember the
letter B. Be quiet, please.
Letter B.
Let's say letter Bravo.
A lot of Najib in this meeting.
Jose?
Teacher. Go to the list. Go to the list. Better.
You see, that's why we're not politicians. Now I understand. Now I understand the assembly. Why they they never.
Right.
Jesus Christ. We will throw shoes.
Like
we will
throw Congress.
Teacher, exactly. How do you say revoltoso?
Revolches? Revolches. Okay. Yeah, we are revolches. All right, very good. Now let's go to the list before we start killing each other. So you already know the rules. Julio, turn on the camera. Turn on the camera really quick. You know the rules. Just letting you know for next level. In reality, they told me you're supposed to have the camera on at least 90% of the class. So I'm just letting you know. If they tell me that you have to turn it on.
Teacher, I have to go to the class, but I was.
Oh, you have to leave right now? Okay, Lorena is here. Okay, good.
Yes,
all right.
Sorry.
All right, everyone, turn on the camera. Thank
but
you.
But I'm present.
Yes, you are. Yeah. Good, thank you, Lorena.
Thank you.
All right, everyone, turn on the camera really quick so we can go through this.
Yes, sir.
All right, Caesar, sorry. No? Caesar is gone. Caesar.
Christian Calles, oh, you are in the dark. Turn the light.
Christian doesn't like to show his face. He's on the street right now. He's on the street right now on the wall.
The street is sleeping.
Insaforp need to see.
He's in the corner right now of the house. All right, everyone. So let's check the list. So here we go. Julio Alberto.
Present.
Good. Christian Calles.
The dark. Present.
All right. Marlon Castillo.
Present.
Good. Jose Castro.
Present.
There he is. David Dominguez.
Present.
Good. Franklin Flores.
Present.
Cool. Gustavo Garcia.
Present.
Nice. Isaí Gonzalez.
Present.
Cool. Jorge Hernandez. Oh, I guess he sent me a message. Need to check what's up. All right. René, not here. Lorena Larin was here. She had to go. She was here in Insaforp. Saul Mendez.
I'm here.
Cool. Juan Molina. Oh, he just sent me a message. Apparently his car broke down. Samuel Montoya, too, send me a message. All right, put it here. Carla, sorry. Ariel Posas.
Present.
There she is. Luis Ramos.
Present.
Thank you. Mr. Gilberto Rosa.
Present.
There he is. Cesar Sanchez. Cesar. Hello.
Here.
Oh, there he is. We didn't hear you. All right. Cool. Omar Sanchez.
Here. Present.
Cool. And Baltasar Torres.
Present.
Did I skip someone? Don't die. Don't fall asleep. All right, everybody. So, any questions for today? We're good?
No question.
All right, guys. So, as always, it's always a pleasure to have you in class. Really happy to hear you, and I hope to see you tomorrow. Have a beautiful night.
Thank you.
Bye, guys. Enjoy your dinner.